Good morning, New Beginnings. It's me, Pastor Danish House. Today is Thursday, July 9th, 2020. Thank you for joining me for this daily update and devotional video. I'm glad you decided to make me part of your life today, and I'm delighted that you're part of my life as well. Hey, thanks for praying for my retreat day yesterday. It was a good day. I spent a good chunk of time working my way through Matthew chapter 24. Reading some books and spending some time in prayer. I thought it was a very productive and fruitful day, so thank you for your prayers, and I hope that it pays off when time comes to preach on Matthew 24 in a few weeks. It's a very important and very tightly packed passage of scripture, and I really want to do a good job of it. Last night was the Temporary Rebuild Advisory Committee, and they finished their work last night, which is exciting, and looking forward to receiving their final report. So thank the Lord for that. Today, Thursday the 9th, is 180 Youth tonight at 6:30 p.m. here at Arlington Reformed Church. Come on out for that if you're a youth group age. Celebrate Recovery for Women is online at Zoom at 7:30 p.m. So if you're a woman and you want to get help with your hurts, habits, and hang-ups, if you want to receive support from your sisters in Christ, 7:30 p.m. on Zoom tonight. That's exciting stuff. This week I've been working through the question, why do bad things happen to good people? And on Tuesday I did why, and addressed the question of God's ways being bigger than our ways. And yesterday I did do bad things and talked about the existence of good and bad things, and that sometimes we don't have the perspective that we need to even determine whether an event will wind up being good or bad for us. Oftentimes our estimation of those things even will change as the years go by. Today I want to talk about the word happen. Why do bad things happen? And I just want to point out the fact that things, events in our world do not just happen. Events in our world do not just happen. There's no such thing as a random occurrence. At the very least, God foreknows and allows everything that happens. This is the consistent testimony of Scripture, that God is sovereign, that God exercises a measure of control over every event that happens in this world. Sometimes, I mean, at the very least, God acts to limit the evil that happens in this world, but God also acts to inspire good bring about a good resolution for events that take place. This is a very complicated area of philosophy and theology, asking the question, just to what extent does God's sovereignty operate? Is God sovereign to the extent that we as humans do not any longer have actual free will? It's a very challenging question. I'm not going to be able to answer it in a daily update and devotional video, but I do want to cover a few little passages about this, which are just really crucial, such as Ephesians 1, verse 11, which tells us that God works all things according to the counsel of his will. That God works all things according to the counsel of his will. Of course, most Christians are familiar with Romans 8, verse 28, and we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good, for those who are called according to his purpose. All things work together for good, and in Ephesians, it's God who works all things according to the counsel of his will. But is that just, you know, is that God just taking an evil thing that just happened on its own and shepherding it to a better conclusion? Well, Proverbs 16:33 is an interesting one in this respect. Proverbs 16:33 says, "The lot is cast into the lap, but its every decision is from the Lord." The lot is cast into the lap, but its every decision is from the Lord. A lot is like a dice roll, right? I think about this verse, Proverbs 16:33, a lot in my life, because I play a lot of board games. We will roll a dice in my family to determine who goes first in a particular game, or we'll play games that involve shuffling of cards to randomize the deck, or to roll dice to make certain things happen. And, you know, it feels to us like those things are random. There's a big popular saying in statistics which says that dice have no memory, that every roll of the dice is just as likely to wind up on any particular face as any other. But what the Bible testifies is that there's no such thing as a random event. There's no such thing as a random event. At the very least, God allows things to happen in his permitting them to happen sovereignly. And to a greater degree of sovereignty, there appear to be times in which God foreordains and directly directs things to happen in a particular way. Now, there's a wide variety of Christian understandings of how this actually works. How does this work with the idea of free will? But at the core of it is a belief that God is sovereign. So when we ask, why do bad things happen to good people? Things don't just happen. Things don't just happen. God is sovereign. And that can be confusing when things happen that we believe are bad. But it can also be incredibly comforting, because it means that no situation spirals out of God's control. No situation is beyond God's ability to make it right. And if things were random, if things happened that God could not foresee and could not deal with, then there'd be very little point in prayer, and there'd be very little comfort in trusting in God. But because we know that God is sovereign, even though that presents us with some questions about the bad things, the things that we think of as bad happening in the world, it at least gives us the comfort of knowing that God is on the throne and that nothing happens that's beyond his control. Let's just take a minute and reflect on the sovereignty of God. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are indeed sovereign over all. We thank you that you are the living and breathing God who does work all things according to the counsel of your will. And thank you that the counsel of your will is good for all those who love you and are called according to your purpose. And you shepherd all things to a good conclusion for all of us. Thank you that there is no such thing as a random event, but that you are sovereign in every situation. God, we yield to your sovereignty, and we yield to your grace. We thank you that so many good things happen to us every day. Lord, I pray for our church. I pray for all the things that are going on. I pray for the youth group tonight at 6:30. I pray that you would bless the youth, that they would learn more from your word, and that they would fellowship with one another and be a beneficial challenge to one another. Bless Joel and all those who are volunteering with Joel, Lord, to minister to our youth. And I pray that you bless that time tonight. Thank you for the work of the Temporary Rebuild Advisory Committee last night. Thank you for helping them as they're working their report to a conclusion. Lord, we thank you for their good work in that regard. And I pray for tonight's Celebrate Recovery for Women meeting on Zoom. May it be a blessing to all those who attend, and may their hearts be comforted by the presence of their sisters. Lord, you're a good God, and we trust in you, and we give you praise. We thank you today for being our good God and Master. We love you, and we trust you, and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, New Beginnings, thanks for hanging out with me today. It's been great being with you. Please tune in again. I look forward to talking to you again tomorrow.